Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Marathon Mondays with Mal in the front of the mothership. We call it the mothership because we've got three locations with Marathon Coach, the best luxury converter in the history of the world or other worlds out there. Three locations, of course, you guys already know Florida, Texas, and here at the mothership, what we call it, in Cobourg, Oregon, where all the coaches are built. I sound like a tobacco auctioneer, Armand. You hear that? What's going on, everybody? Coach 1289 headed off with the new owner right behind us. Armand and I were checking out the production floor this morning and looking for what was going on, and we're gonna head on into the building while we walk by Coach 1289. 1289 headed off with the new owners. So congratulations to the new owner. We're gonna walk in and we're gonna look at a few things this morning. We're gonna look at the boutique. The boutique is one of the cool things about, if you're a Marathon owner, you wanna come to Marathon. The boutique has several items like, you know, this jacket right here. This is a new model of jacket. Also, polo shirts, hats, trinkets, everything from Marathon logoed pocket knives, if you will. What does "if you will" mean? Feel like I picked that up from The Big Lebowski or something. Or no, what have you. That's from The Big Lebowski. All right. Coming through the lobby of the corporate headquarters, we'll walk right over here and we'll head right into the boutique. So for those of you who haven't seen it before on the Marathon Monday show, this is the boutique. And for the most part, it's Marathon gear, it's Marathon clothing, from t-shirts to polo shirts to jackets to hats. Here's even a Marathon logoed lantern. That's kind of cool. You can hang it up, what have you. Here's that pocket, what have you. See, I integrated that. Here's a Marathon logoed, here, let me see if I can hold it up for you. Marathon logoed pocket knife. That's really a cool item.
These are sweet because they pop out.
Oh, these things pop out, that's right. Armand just pointed out that these things pop out, these little lights. I won't do it because guess what? I'll never get them back in. What's in the mystery bag, Armand?
You
know what? I think it's like a first aid kit. Usually first aid kits are in red or yellow, but that guy's in black to match everything else. This is the boutique. Many of you have asked if some of these items are gonna be available on the Marathon website. I believe a select few are. I've said that many, many times before. And believe me, on behalf of so many people, I am pushing our marketing team to get that done. Armand right there behind the camera is part of the marketing team, and I do a lot with the marketing team, and they're very, very busy. So one of the things that I will drop in the ear of Pete Sutton is a reminder that if it can happen, we'd like to get some of these items on the Marathon website. This is one of my favorite logos. It's the Motorsports Marathon Coach logo. You can see this on a couple of items. Here's a hat that has it on there. And this shirt, you see Dave Bash wearing this shirt a lot. Marathon has quite the commitment to motorsports, whether it be amateur collectible hot rods or it be all the way up to NASCAR. We have quite the commitment to motorsports. And for those of you who watched NASCAR this weekend, had a wild race. That's always fun to watch. The Wall of Brag, I think we've shown that before, so we'll just walk right by it. That is a wall of items that represent coaches that were sold or currently owned by celebrities of some sort. Here we are, Coach 1289, which we saw out front, was parked right here about 15 minutes ago. And congratulations to the new owner of Quad Slide 1289. That guy is gonna be headed out with the new owner this morning. So it's no longer there. We're gonna walk just through the production floor here. I'm gonna show you a few things. It's a real busy Monday morning, so we're not gonna hold up production at all. But if you've got any questions or thoughts or comments, please let Armand know. He can see some of them. Maybe we can get to them when we are live. Let's go this way. A motorhome racing league?
Yeah.
I'm with that.
I think that's
Wouldn't that be great?
That's
motorhome racing league. I'd have to figure out who would be the commissioner of the motorhome racing league. What would it be called? I mean, there's all kinds of blue sky ideas when it comes to that. There's all kinds of things that we could really come up with. One of the things you can see when we walk the production floor is just all of these coaches are in different modes of, I say modes, that's probably the wrong term, in different levels of production. Some are nearing completion, some just came down from paint, and this one looks like it's been on the production floor for about 3-4 weeks. You can tell because the wires are pulled. Nice. Yeah, we will do some racing. Beautiful coaches. We're just gonna hit up this paint job right here. And then we're gonna turn around. What do you think of that paint job, you guys? Isn't that absolutely beautiful? Blacked out wheels, blacked out rub rails. You see our detail team is still working on that paint job, getting it ready. That coach is for sale. I believe it's $1,340. That's something. I can't wait, Armand, to get that guy outside in the natural light. Someone just pointed out that tricked out motors. That's pretty funny. Well, we won't get into tricked out motors because we're gonna have something to show you here in the coming future in the next couple of months that's pretty tricked out when it comes to the motor. Another thing about a motorhome racing team, like physically racing Prevos, RVs. Wouldn't that be something? Let's cut across this way, Armand. And here, what you have is the opportunity to see two H3 double slides right next to each other. 1343 right here, which has got about a month and a half left in production. And on the other side, you have a shell, an H3 double slide shell. That's how we get it from Prevo. Isn't that beautiful? I say it's beautiful because it's so simple when it comes in. It's so simple, it's got kind of a beautiful simplicity to it when you see the shell. It's really cool to look at. It never gets old for me. H3 double slide, 1343. I'm really gonna like these walls when everything gets, all the protective coating's gonna get pulled. We've been in this coach before on Marathon Mondays, and I'm excited to show you this. One of the reasons I'm excited to show you this when it gets completed is it's one of the only coaches that's still on the production floor that's still for sale. That's kind of the thing that I wanted to tell you guys about this morning, is that these coaches are selling so fast that if you're thinking about upgrading, if you're thinking about getting into a marathon and you're using Marathon Mondays as a show, as a platform for research, which is the number one reason that we do it. Don't hesitate. Custom coaches, we are way out on custom coaches, but we can still fit you in somewhere into that production plan. But also, the coaches are selling so quickly that they're selling before they get completed on the production floor. And this guy, 1343, an H3 double slide, and I think you guys have seen this floor plan. It's got that real creative, lots of storage in the bedroom. This guy's still for sale. But most of these coaches that are out here on the production floor, they've already sold. We've got a ton out there. We do have a brand new X3 coach, 1325. If you're interested, you know how to get a hold of me, MALW@marathoncoach.com. And another thing that I did, and I don't even think Armand knows this. Friday afternoon, I started a marathon. He does know. I started a Marathon Mondays with Mal Instagram account. So look up Marathon Mondays with Mal, all one word, I guess it is, on Instagram. I'm going to be pushing a lot of content and small reels, which is basically small videos, onto Instagram. Kind of a little bit of lighter than some of my other posts. Fun stuff, things that you never see before. And so check out Instagram. Go and follow me there. And we'll have some fun off of the script. We will definitely go off script on Instagram, because that's what we're gonna do there. It's gonna be fun. Let's go back down this way. My son is starting Little League today. I'm pretty excited about that. I've got a background in baseball, and so I am excited for my son, who's 6 years old, to get into baseball. And this will be his first T-ball team. So let's take a look at this paint job, Armand. There's something about looking at an X3, 1349. This guy is still for sale. Look at the front end of this. This coach came out of paint about 3 weeks ago. This is an Alan Christensen designed interior. So you know there's gonna be an elephant somewhere, but take a look at the texturing on the front of that paint job. There's been a lot of conversation about paint jobs lately out there in the RV world. I will put the Marathon paint jobs that we've been putting out over the last year and a half against any paint jobs out there. There's a lot of companies that do beautiful paint jobs. And I will put Marathon right up there. We do some really dynamic stuff. We do some really classy stuff. But also, we're truly a custom shop. The customers who custom order a coach, they come in and they work with our designers, whether it be Sarah or Pete, and they can design the elements and the colors of their paint scheme. That's truly a custom coach. This guy is gonna be a designer choice, which means it's still for sale. It is not a custom, but it's still at the level of a custom because all of the items inside it are gonna be the same. What is this, Armand? I'm getting into someone's work. I won't move that too much. 1338 cabinetry. 1344, another X3. Let me go take a look up here before we get out of here for the day. Here's one thing I can show you real quick. We've talked about it a lot. What you see here is this is the fiberglass dashboard that Marathon builds in-house. Now we build this dashboard in-house in our fiberglass shop. Here in Coburg, at the world headquarters, we build all these things right here in the same building, from the paint to the dash, the upholstery, to the cabinetry, our electronics. We even build some of our own electrical boards. But the thing is about what I'm seeing here is this cockpit is just starting to take shape, and this is 1344s. This is custom made for 1344. Nothing is cookie cutter at Marathon. This dash, this piece of fiberglass that's in here, was built only for Coach 1344. That's really cool. And of course, that'll be leather wrapped. This cutout on top, that cutout right there is for the GPS system to come out with the push of a button. Let's take a look back here. It's break time here, so we can come in here and see what's going on.
Before they go nuts looking for it.
Oh, I know. If I don't put that tape measure back, you know, it'll go missing. I'll get blamed, which I should be.
We have video proof
that I was touching it. You know, don't let a salesman touch the tools because they don't know what they're doing with it anyway, right? So here we are in the backside of an X3. And you can see just how much room is back here before all the infrastructure gets built. And I'm at 6 foot tall and I'm standing up back here. This is a rear closet. There will be cabinetry back here for storage, but there will also be audio visual back here. Wiring is just being set up. Let me step over these tools, but not touch them. Here's a shower right here. That's pretty cool. Looks like they've got some of the plans, and you can already see the cabinetry, excuse me, the wall laminate on the outside of the shower wall here is already starting to take shape. So all kinds of different phases here when it goes to making a good coach. Lots of things happen at one time. And it takes, you know, 4 or 5 months to build a coach, but it all will come together. And as you can see, I'll let Armand get a nice shot of this production floor as we sign off for the day. There's a lot going on, a lot of busy production. A lot of coaches being built. All right, you guys. So that's another episode. I think we're at, what, 215 today, Armand? Episode 215 never gets old, bringing you guys the latest from Marathon. Feel free to reach out to me at any time if you're looking to get into a coach. Being a part of the Marathon team is an honor for me, and I love communicating with all of you out there, whether you're doing research for a new one, you're looking to upgrade, or you've owned 5 Marathons and you're ready for a new one. MALW@marathoncoach.com. And Andrew Steele talking about racing. I'll tell you what, Andrew, maybe we could set that up. Maybe Andrew should be the commissioner of our league, of our racing league, RV Racing League. What are we going to call it? Be yourself and do good things from the production floor of Cobourg, Oregon. Have a good Monday, everybody. Take care.